I'd like to talk to you about Canadian green bonds and nuclear power.
I haven't seen you before. How may I help you?
Oh.
My miniature pony.
Is there anything else I can get for you?
Yeah, I really need some condensed milk.
Canadian green bonds have an exclusion list. Things that cannot be financed with the bonds.
Let me have a Three Musketeers and a ballpoint pen, one of those combs there.
Did you know that you can't finance arms manufacturing with Canadian green bonds?
I love beef.
Did you know you can't make tobacco products with Canadian green bonds?
May I have a comb and a TV guide, please?
Yeah.
Of the six exclusions listed, only two are actually pertinent to fighting climate change. The exclusion of fossil fuels makes sense, but if that was the only thing we excluded, we wouldn't have a list.
Some Castillos? Those?
But we need a list because the exclusion of nuclear power makes no sense.
And take this keychain.
Yeah.
What else? Deck of cards, probably need one of those.
Yeah.
Okay. The condoms in a loop, please.
In fact, the whole point of Canadian green bonds might just be to exclude nuclear power.
Until you became the Minister of Natural Resources, the words nuclear energy did not cross the lips of anybody from the Government of Canada.
Our previous Minister of the Environment, Seamus O'Regan, he had this to say about nuclear power.
Zero emission. There is no panacea for this. There is no, if we just had more solar panels. No. Solar panels figure into it. Wind figures into it. Electrification figures into it. Hydro. All of this stuff. And by the way, there are consequences to every single one of these actions, to be very, very clear, right? Every single wind turbine takes 60,000 pounds of copper. I mean, I am amazed by the number of people who crap on me for supporting the mining industry. How the hell do you think we're going to build the batteries? How the heck do you think we're going to get to the electric vehicles? How do you think these things are built? CANDU reactors are still the gold standard around the world. We are a tier one nuclear nation. And we have an excellent regulatory regime around nuclear. It is actually a competitive strength for us. So we would be foolhardy to put that to one side. It is a part of it. I don't look to nuclear as a panacea, but nuclear gives us that stability that Ontario has enjoyed in this country more than any other province for decades now. And we need more of it. The Americans are on it. You know, right through Trump, they were on this. I don't understand other jurisdictions that have given it up. Germany particularly. I mean, Germany increased its coal extraction after they decided to shut down nuclear plants.
There'd been a church here since the 12th century. The Garzweiler open cast mine. It is about to consume five more villages. More than 40 have already disappeared into its abyss.
In 2021, Seamus O'Regan was shuffled out. Our current Minister of Greenpeace had this to say about nuclear power.
I know you have a long history in environmental activism and you've been a principled opponent of nuclear energy throughout your pre-ministerial career. Have you reevaluated your position based on the scientific consensus on that? You know, based on the IPCC saying wind and solar are not enough, we need nuclear?
It's really the market that decides which technologies we're going to perform in tomorrow's role. And it's not me in Ottawa or someone else that's going to say this technology won't go ahead, that technology won't go ahead.
Yet that is exactly what Bilbo has done by excluding nuclear from the green bond framework.
Hold on, please. Hey, I got to ask the manager about a price here.
Oh, wait, no.
Tony.
No.
Tony, how much for the keychain?
I don't, it's not for me, I swear. Okay, I don't even have keys. No, I just want the rubbers and the lube, and I don't care about any of this.
What's the cost on the keychain?
Don't.
Tony, the guy wants to buy a keychain. How much?
I don't want the keychain.
When Gilbo worked for Greenpeace, they were actively misinforming the public about nuclear power, claiming that it was high carbon.
CO2 emissions? Not with nuclear. There's not a cleaner energy source out there.
Now calculating, carbon footprint of nuclear is much higher than wind and solar.
Everything pales in comparison to nuclear.
Nuclear power is low carbon. Canadian nuclear power is ultra low carbon. the single lowest carbon electricity source in Canada. But it's excluded. So when asked why, here's what we heard.
While the federal government's investing in modular reactor programs as a clean energy source, the Green Bond Program actually prohibits investments in nuclear energy. So can you explain what to some people appears to be a contradiction here?
We basically adopted what are the best practices out there for that first issuance of green bonds.
Right, right. But I mean, Ontario has shown that using nuclear energy has been helping to remove carbon from the power grid in that province. So do you consider nuclear energy a key tool in reducing greenhouse gas emissions or not?
That's really not what we're saying with the issuance of green bonds. Again, we looked at what are the best practices.
Hi, it's Brian Platt from Bloomberg. Why are you excluding nuclear from the green bonds?
We wanted to make sure that we harmonized with the international best practices. And as you know from what we see in Europe, nuclear is not part of that mix.
In fact, Europe's green taxonomy includes nuclear power, allows the funding of nuclear power. Europe's inclusion came at the end of a detailed study of nuclear's life cycle impact. That study concluded nuclear had a no more significant impact on the environment than renewables. In many categories, it had a much smaller impact.
Russ, man, check it out, yo, look who's buying Jimmy's!
Toronto Dominion Asset Management defended nuclear as green. They did that right now, just as I'm recording this.
You want these gift wrapped?
Crammed into a list of sins, alcohol, gambling, tobacco, arms manufacturing, is our Minister of Greenpeace's anti-nuclear agenda he claimed did not exist.
It's not me in Ottawa or someone else that's going to say this technology won't go ahead, that technology won't go ahead.
This is an insult to the 76,000 working Canadians supporting the nuclear sector. That number might surprise you. Did you know that Canadian nuclear power has a 95% Canadian supply chain? From the mining of Canadian uranium to the high-paid staff at our CANDU power plants, these 76,000 Canadians are climate heroes. Gilbo lives in Quebec, where there is an abundance of hydropower. Yay, hydro! Hydropower employees are climate heroes too. But Gilbo is making it harder for the rest of Canada to decarbonize, not easier. By appointing Gilbo to the Ministry of Environment and Climate Change, it's as if we appointed a homeopath to the Ministry of Health. While Gilbo worked for Greenpeace, this is the kind of disinformation Greenpeace was funding.
We don't need to invent anything new. We just need to stop wasting time with distractions like nuclear power. Come on, let's build the future we all want to see.
Grams of CO2 per kilowatt hour? No, that has never been true. European nuclear is 6 grams. Canadian nuclear is 3.2 grams, a tiny fraction of what they're claiming. I think it's kind of funny that alcohol and cigarettes were specifically excluded from green bond funding. Were we going to drink and smoke our way out of climate change? Were we going to do it with machine guns? But it's no laughing matter that nuclear power is excluded. The rationale given is untrue. Europe's decision to include nuclear power can be read by anyone. It's a meaty 387-page study. They did their homework. Stephen Gilbo should read it. Maybe we should all read it. But before you start reading, please join me in signing the official parliamentary petition demanding that nuclear power be included in the Canadian Green Bond Program. Over 10,000 Canadians have already signed. This can be fixed. This will be fixed. Head to c4ne.ca. You'll be directed to the petition. That's Canadians for Nuclear Energy. I'm Gordon McDowell, and I live in Calgary, Alberta, where we are going to decarbonize with the help of nuclear power.
You want these gift wrapped?